This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. So glad that you are able to join us back at Speak the Word. I pray that all is well and God is continuously blessing you. I pray that you had a joyful Thanksgiving and that you took time to give the Lord thanks for the bountiful blessing. Sure, we did have to experience the Thanksgiving holiday through the new normal, but God gave us grace that we were able to realize that in the midst of all that's going on, that we are blessed. I pray that you are continuously practicing safe distancing and that you are focused on following the guideline in order that not only that you may be blessed by being obedient, that those around you that you love and work with also may be blessed. I pray also you remember those who may be in dire need or going through tough situations. And remind them that God still loves you. This week, we're going to be coming from a very familiar passage of scripture. We're going to be dealing with Psalms verses 4 and 5. And the title of this message will be The Attitude of Thanksgiving. The Attitude of Thanksgiving. We'll be back after this selection.
Jesus, come on.
welcome back. And I pray that you were blessed with the selection and that God will continue to shine his grace upon you. We will go immediately into the word. The word will be found in Psalms 100 verses 4 and 5. And it reads as follows. It said, enter into his gates with thanksgiving, into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting. And his truth endureth in all to all generation. I have read to you Psalms 100 verses 4 and 5. I'd like to speak to you from the subject of the attitude of thanksgiving. The attitude of thanksgiving. As we are approaching the end of another year, there's so many times that many people deal with depression, they deal with suicidal tendency, they're dealing with low self-esteem because when they see and remember, the devil place upon the mind all the negative things. Yes, it is true that we got to deal with a year 2000, which was a difficult year, a year of unprecedented, a year that was different from any other year that we ever faced. We start off the year with a pandemic and we move from a pandemic into social discord and social unrest and racism and a divided nation. We're dealing with two candidates with opposite opinion and then election time and they're pulling the country apart. We are dealing with also economic disparities where people are lost jobs and the economy is up and down and we're facing higher prices at the grocery stores and everywhere we go, we're making the same money or either less money, but the prices are still going up. We are even facing that we had to change our reality of living, that many of us are restricted by separating ourselves by 6 feet. We wear a mask all the time for protection. And we are not able to come together even in the house of the Lord the way we want to because of this pandemic. But I got news for you. We are still blessed. If you are under the sound of my voice, if you are able to look at this video, then you are still being blessed by God. Yes, it's a different time, but I got news for you. It's a transitional time. It's a temporary time that if we just be obedient, we can make our way through this and receive the blessing that God has for us on the other side. As we look into the scripture, the first verse says, make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye land. He went on to say that as David began to pen this, he began to let us know that we should be making and not just a noise, not a sad noise, but a joyful noise. That when people see us, that they see the glory of God shining from inside on the outside. That they see a happiness, not a fake smile, but a real smile, because we realize that God is still in control. Paul the Apostle in the book of Philippians records that he learned how to be abound and abased. He learned how to be up, he learned how to be down. He learned how to deal with the mountaintop experience as well as the valley lows. But in it all, he said he counted all joy because he realized that God was working a plan. God was building him. God was strengthening him in order to do the work that he had called him to do. He also rest assured that this is only a temporary place. This life that we live in is only temporary, but we're going to be in a better place, a place where we will be in the glory of the Lord. So therefore, we must trust and we must obey him and we must keep the faith. He goes on, he says, serve the Lord with gladness and come before his presence with thanksgiving. That we need to be glad when we have the chance to serve the Lord. Also, we also, as we dealing and you get down to verse 3, it says, know ye that the Lord is God and is he that made us and not we ourselves. And that we are sheep. He's declaring there that we are the people of God and that God still has everything under control. And it's not that we are in control, but God is in control. I know we got two president candidates were working and one was elected, but yet they do not have the final say. God has the final say. Now, when we get down to the heart of the attitude of thanksgiving, that verse 4, he said, he entered into the courts with thanksgiving. which means that he showed up before he even got to the temple. He already had thanksgiving on his heart. He was already praising God. In order to be a worshiper of praises, you must be able to worship him in the midst of the trials and tribulation. You got to be able to worship him because you're living a lifestyle of a worshiper. You are living a lifestyle of thanksgiving because you realize that God got everything under control. All things work to the good of them who are called according to the purpose. It may be tough right now. It may be strenuous, but it's working for your good, that God is strengthening you. He's building you into the vessel that he wants you to be. Then verse 5 said, for the Lord is good. And now we got to realize that no matter what we deal with, that God is doing it because he is good. And not only that, the next part said, and his mercy endureth, it is everlasting, that his mercy goes on. He don't see, there's one thing good about God, that his mercy do not run out, but his mercy is everlasting. Now, I can hear the prophet of old that said that he woke up with new mercy. Jeremiah said he woke up with new mercy, that this morning that we didn't have to start off on the mercy that we had yesterday, but we woke up with new mercy of God, that God is still merciful unto our shortcoming. He's still merciful to our short think. He's still merciful to our rebellious spirit. He's still merciful for all the wrong things, and he's still giving us a chance to give it right. And then the last part said, his truth endureth to all generation. I'm glad to know that his truth don't just stop right here, but his truth is everlasting. Matter of fact, in the New Testament it said, before the crossing of the T, the dotting of the I, this whole world will pass away before his word shall fail. And so he is letting us know that as we read the scripture, that God is giving us a promise, that he has given us a lifestyle that we could go forward, that we could give him the praise. So therefore, make a joyful noise. Therefore, lift up your voice and be thankful and praise his name, because he is worthy of the praise. And most of all, he paid a price for our sins as he died on the cross over 2,000 years. But early on Sunday morning, he got up and declared that all power was in his hand. Lord, I want to bless you right now because I'm thankful for what you have done. I want to thank you for my family, my health, and my strength. I want to thank you for a loving Jesus who died on the cross. I want to thank you for the promise that realized that this is temporary, that what I go through is just temporary. Like the scripture said, this too will pass. I am thankful that one day when this life is over, I'm going to the land that shall be flowing with milk and honey. But until that day, I will give him a praise because he's worthy. So I want you to adopt the attitude of praise. Yes, we're going to go through what we're going to go through, but be thankful because as we go through it, it's making us better. It's making us stronger. It's making us to be more what he wants us to be. So adopt, take on the lifestyle of a worshiper. Take on the lifestyle of a thankful heart, a thankful Christian, and watch God lift your heart up. Watch God change your mindset and change your situation and make you better. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we come right now to give you the praise and honor. We come, Father, because we love you and we bless your name. We come, Father, realize it had not been for you, we wouldn't be here. So we just bless and honor your name because you're awesome God, you're wonderful counselor. Father, we want to thank you for giving us the instruction on how to be thankful in the midst of this trying situation. Father, I pray for those who are contemplating suicide right now, that you will remove that demon from them and let them know that God is able to set them free. Father, we also pray right now for those that are oppressed, that you will uplift the spirit. We pray for those who are dealing with financial difficulty, that they will be reminded that a cattle upon 1,000 hills are yours. Father, we pray for those who are living alone, remember that they are never alone, that you're always beside us. And Father, we want to pray right now for those that do not know you, but yet are seeking to know you, that they may begin to open their heart and pray that God would come into their lives and they will surrender unto you, and you begin to lead them and guide them, that they may walk in the newness and walk in the joy and walk in the peace of knowing you. Father, we thank you right now. Father, we bless your name. Father, we honor you because you are awesome God. And Father, we give you the praise. And Father, as we go forth, let's just bless his name. because he is worthy. We pray this prayer in thy son Jesus' name. Amen. Until next time, remember and continue to speak the word, because there's power in the word. See you next time.
For times you protected, and I didn't even know, when I leaned on my own understanding to stay in control. You put people in my life to manifest your grace, till the day I was ready to really see your face. I wanna say thank you, thank you, Lord, for keeping your hand on me. To me, you extended your favor and you used your key to turn my life around. Now I'm walking in the light. You're revealing my future and it's bright, so bright. I want to see. Thank you. Times I know what my God like, it left me level to the ground. Then your love, lifted me to all that I need. Oh, give thanks to the Lord. Oh, give thanks to the Lord.